just trying to make things happen, being like a broke street kid who everyone's like, you got talent, so I'm thinking like talent is gonna carry you someplace. Lesson kids, talent on its own is not gonna take you anywhere. There's so many other factors. So that day I just stopped, decided like, all right, I'm done with this. Like, I'm not getting anywhere. I was not having fun at the time because I was so focused on like trying to film and trying to do all this. I didn't really have the resources, didn't really have my life structured to facilitate what I wanted to do. When I met my wife now, we're dating, like my friends would always talk about skateboarding, me skateboarding. For that 2 years, like I didn't mention skateboarding to people. And she asked me, like, what is all this skateboarding that people talk about? Oh yeah, I used to skateboard, like that's what I wanted to do forever. And she's like, how come you don't do it now? And I explained everything to her, and she's like, well, that's stupid. And so I started skating again. She was like, well, if you skate, I'll buy you shoes, you know? Like, I'll buy you whatever you need to skate as long as you skate. Which at the time, you know, nobody really had ever put that much support behind me, just on a personal level. My name is Norman Woods. I live in Los Angeles, and I'm a professional skateboarder and a musician. I play in a band called Alternative Facts. We got together about November of last year. Basically, the drummer, Carlos, who's a childhood friend of mine, we used to skate together, go to punk rock shows. He approached me when we were at a bar and was like, let's start playing music. And I had been playing music before, but it had almost been a year since the previous incarnation I was playing with broke up. I had written all these songs, and I actually recorded them with me playing them by myself. LA Record Magazine reviewed the songs, but I never even put out a release. We never played the shows because the band dissolved. So Carlos and I started jamming together, and we started learning those songs. In December, we got offered to play a gig. So I got my neighbor, whose name is Olaf, and he plays in a band called Psychic Jiu-Jitsu, to come on and play bass. So we've been playing shows since December. It's like a power trio thing. Rock music, but not just straightforward rock. It's got some other influences. My favorite music is the band Television and the band Love. So all the cross sections between those two is probably what it resembles the most. Right now I have a new board, or two new boards that are coming out from Brujeria Skateboards. It's actually Brujeria, that's how you pronounce it. It means witchcraft in Spanish. Patrick Reedy, who is the founder of the company and also does all the art, is a friend of mine. When I was riding for Warco Skateboards previously, Patrick and I had become friends, and he had mentioned riding for them to me before, but I was trying to make things work. So when I left Warco last November, it was kind of a no-brainer, since he and I had a core built up already, and we had similar aesthetic interests, similar interests in general, so I just said, yeah, I'm gonna run with it. It also helped that they were going to allow me to have a lot of input into the decisions the company made, into the art direction of the company, not only concerning my boards, like, but just considering the layouts of things, and also the other people who wrote for the team. The older I get, the more I feel the need to be a three-dimensional human being. Been teaching skate lessons for about 7 years. I started with a company called Go Skate, filled out an application, and didn't hear from them for about a year or two, so I probably forgot all about it. Got a call, started doing lessons. Turned out to be pretty decent at it, so word of mouth amongst parents started to spread, and now I do a good amount of private lessons, and sometimes I'll do one from Go Skate, but LA doesn't seem to be too hot with the skate lessons, for them at least, so mostly do private ones. So right now it's May of 2017, and I just had a video part come out, which was for Thief Trucks. It was put up on the Transworld Skateboarding website. I'm gonna be having a pro truck released for them as well, which is a big honor for me. Any truck company probably has like 200 people that rides for it. It's probably like 1 or 3% of those people to get a pro truck. So I'm very honored and happy to have that opportunity. Never really imagined that I would be able to have like a pro board and a pro truck. Like when you're young and skating, it just seems far off because the people you regard highly have their names on boards, so it's difficult to imagine you being in the same league as those people, and I'm very grateful for that.